students, good morning. In yesterday's class, we completed structure of centrioles, fine? As well as we studied what are the different types of cytoskeleton, fine? In today's lecture, we are going to start the next cell component, that is cilia and flagella, fine? Already you know what are the functions of cilia and flagella. So, in the today's class, we are going to study structure, detailed structure of cilia and flagella, okay? So, let's start the next cell organelle, that is cilia and flagella. Okay, cilia and flagella. Okay, we all know that these two are locomotory structures. Okay, these are hair like appendages which help the cell in the movement. But along with movement, these structures also play some other functions also. You might not be knowing these other functions. So, today we will discuss what are the other functions performed by cilia and flagella. Fine. So, these cilia and flagella, these are hair-like outgrowth. Okay. Both are involved in the movement of cell, but there are some important differences in these two structures. Fine. So, we will mention some things for cilia and flagella, and then we will see what are the differences in cilia and flagella in detail. Fine. So, these cilia and flagella, these are hair-like outgrowth, hair-like appendages from cell membrane. Okay. So, these are fine hair-like outgrowth, fine hair-like outgrowths of cell. Okay. Hair-like outgrowth, although there is difference in the length of cilia and flagella also, we will discuss those differences later on. So, these are fine hair-like outgrowths of cell. Okay. There is a difference in the movement of cilia and flagella. Fine. Cilia, these are smaller outgrowths, okay, smaller hair-like outgrowth. When the cilia beat, they cause movement of surrounding fluid or movement of cell. Fine. Cilia are responsible for movement of surrounding fluid. Okay, it works in the old fashion. As you know that the way in which we row our boat. Okay, so in the same way, the cilia, they work. So there is a power stroke, there is a recovery stroke. Fine, and then it causes the movement of cell as well as movement of surrounding fluid. But these flagella, they are much longer in length, okay, and they are responsible for movement of cell. Cilia causes movement of surrounding fluid as well as movement of cell, but flagella, they cause movement of cell only. Fine. So cilia, they work in the oar fashion, okay, they beat like a oar, whereas flagella, they have undulating movement or wavy movement which causes movement of cell. Fine. So we will mention this point. Cilia are smaller outgrowths. Cilia are smaller and work like oar. Okay. Cilia work like oar. They are responsible for movement of surrounding fluid or movement of cell, okay, and causes movement of a cell or surrounding fluid or surrounding medium. It could be any medium, okay. It causes movement of cell or movement of surrounding medium, whereas flagella are longer, okay, they work like a wave manner, so they show wavy movement and causes movement of cell. It causes movement of a cell. Okay. So, these flagella, they are responsible for movement of cell. Fine. Both are hair-like outgrowth. Internally, both of them, they have a similar structure. They develop from centrioles. Yesterday, we studied the structure of centriole. Fine. But there are some important differences in cilia and flagella. So, now we will discuss what are those differences in them in detail. fine. So for that we are going to make two columns, okay, and in that we will discuss these differences. Fine. So you also make two columns, okay. One side we will mention about cilia, okay, and another side we will mention about flagella, okay. So cilia and flagella, fine. Now let's discuss what are the differences in cilia and flagella. First we know that cilia, they are smaller in size, so these are small hair like appendages. So first difference, cilia are small hair like appendages. These are small hair like appendages. Okay, whereas flagella are long thread like appendages. These are long thread like appendages. Okay, first difference we have mentioned here that cilia, they are shorter in size, they are small hair like appendages, slightly thinner, whereas flagella, these are long tail like appendages. If we see the size of cilia, cilia usually 5 micrometer in length. Okay, so if we discuss the size, it is about 5 micrometer in length. Cilia are about 5 micrometer in length, whereas flagella are much more longer. They are about 150 micrometer in length. About 150 micrometer in length. Okay? So you can see the difference in the length of cilia and flagella. Cilia are much shorter. They have size or average length of about 5 micrometer, whereas flagella are much more longer. They have length of about 150 micrometers. Okay, let's discuss the next difference. Next difference related to the numbers. Okay, so cilia, they are numerous. They are mini cilia. Okay, cells have numerous cilia. Numerous cilia. So cilia are many per cell. Okay. So cilia are many per cell. Cells may have so many cilia. Okay. Whereas flagella, cells have limited number of flagella, usually less than 10. So cells have one to few means it is less than 10. Number of flagella less than 10 per cell. Okay. So cells have 1 to 10 or less than 10 flagella. Okay. Next difference we will see, it is location or its occurrence. Cilia are present throughout the surface of cell, whereas flagella are usually inserted anteriorly or it is present only on one side. Fine. So distributed throughout the surface of a cell. Okay, whereas flagella usually anteriorly inserted. Usually inserted anteriorly. Okay, they are usually inserted anteriorly. Let's see the next difference. Okay, the next difference is with respect to its beating. Cilia always beat in a synchronized fashion. All the cilia, they beat at the same time, and that causes movement of cell, okay, or the movement of media. Okay, so cilia beat in a synchronized fashion, in synchronized way. okay? Whereas flagella be independently, okay? Flagella, if a seal has more than one flagella, if it has 4 flagella, 10 flagella, okay? All these flagella, they move independently, okay? Together, they never bait, no? So their beating is independent, okay? Beating is independent, okay? So these flagella, they do not beat in synchronized fashion. Okay, next difference we will see, the type of movement, what type of movements these cilia and flagella show. Okay, so beating, it is synchronized, okay, and it shows rowing type, okay, of movement, okay, that is known as rowing movement, rowing type of movement. Okay, the same way in which we row our boat, okay, huh? So whenever we are rowing a boat, there are two steps, okay, what we do when we row a boat, there are two types of reactions we do, First there is a power stroke and there is a recovery stroke, fine, Whenever we are rowing a boat, at that time two strokes we give. First there is a power stroke and then there is a recovery stroke. So in the same way, this rowing movement of cilia also shows these two states. So first there is a power stroke, first power stroke, and then there is a recovery stroke. Power stroke and a recovery stroke. Flagella show undulating movements, means there is a wavy movement, the way in which these waves are coming, show undulating, so that is known as undulating or wavy movements, undulating or wavy movements, okay, just like our waves, like this, okay, so this type of movement is known as undulating or wavy movement. Cilia causes movement of a cell, or it can cause movement of the surrounding medium, whereas flagella is responsible for movement of cell. Fine. Now let's discuss the next difference. I will rough this so that I can mention here. The seventh difference, there are some types of cilia and flagella. So now let's see what are those types. These cilia, they are of two types. You might have heard these names. These are known as kinocilia and stereocilia. Okay. Cilia, types of cilia. Okay, types of cilia. Okay, there are two types. Okay, first type of cilia, it is known as kinocilia. This is known as kinocilia, and the second one, these are known as stereocilia. Okay, kinocilia and stereocilia. In future, you will get reference of these two words. So just try to understand these two types properly. Kinocilia and stereocilia. From this, kinocilia, these are motile types of cilia. Okay, so these are motile. Okay, these types of cilia, they have normal internal structure that any particular cilia has. So these types of cilia, they cause either movement of cell, or it causes the movement of surrounding medium. So these cilia, they are motile. These cilia present in the hollow cavities of body, like your nasal chamber, your tracheal path. Okay, so the internal layer of trachea, it is lined by these kinocilia that causes movement of air, that causes movement of dust particles, nasal chambers also. In case of fallopian tube also, as you know that fallopian tube, it is internally lined by ciliary epithelium, that causes movement of egg or ova. Fine. So that movement, it is known as ciliary movement. So these cilia which line the internal space of the hollow cavities, okay, like your tracheal chamber, fallopian tube, then tubes of urinary bladder or excretory system, okay, there these cells are responsible for the movement of media. find the. So such types of cilia are known as kinocilia. Okay, these are motile. So examples we will mention. These are your trachea, okay, or tracheal chamber, fallopian tubes, okay, tubes of excretory system, tubes of excretory system, etc. Now, the stereocilia, these are non-motile. Fine, no? These type of cilia, they do not cause any type of motility. They do not cause any type of movement, okay, either of cell, okay. So, these are non-motile. So, if they are non-motile, then what is their use? What is their function? So, such type of cilia, that is your stereocilia, they are present in the sensory organs, okay, like your ear. Okay, so they are sensory in function. They receive the change in impulse, or they receive the kind of stimulus. So they perform sensory function. So perform sensory function. They perform sensory function. So present in sensory organ. Present in sensory organs like ear. Okay, if you have learned the structure of ear in your previous standard, then internal ear, okay, it has stereocilia. These stereocilia, okay, they are responsible to catch the stimulus which is transferred towards central nervous system. Fine. So such cilia are known as stereocilia. So if we go for mentioning functions of cilia, okay, right now we were knowing that cilia are responsible for movement of cell. Okay, now let's see what are some more functions of cilia. So I will mention here functions of cilia. So first we know that obviously there is a movement. So movement, it is a first function of cell. Okay, the second function, that is capturing. Okay, second function is capturing, either capturing of food particle, capturing of air, capturing of dust particles. Fine. And the third function, that is sensation. Okay, as these type of cilia, they are present in sensory organ, they also perform function of sensation. Fine. So these are three functions which are performed by cilia. Fine. Now let's study what are the types of flagella. Okay, flagella are also of two types. Flagella are also of two types. These two types are based on the basis of, these two types are made on the basis of their size as well as shape. First one, that is tinsel type. Okay, tinsel type of flagella. And second one, it is known as whiplash type of flagella. Okay, tinsel type of flagella and whiplash type of flagella. So tinsel type of flagella, it is just like your hunter. Okay, it is go on tapering toward its end. So it looks same like your hunter. Okay, you have studied the structure of bacterial flagella. So that flagella was of tinsel type. Okay, so tinsel, tinsel type, it is just like a feather, okay, sorry, that whiplash type, it is hunter like, okay, whereas tinsel type, it is feather like, okay. This tinsel type of flagellum, it is present in some spores of lower plants, okay. Whiplash type of flagella, you have studied such type of flagella in the bacteria. But the structure of flagella, it is different in prokaryotic and eukaryotic cell. But if we discuss the structure of flagella, the bacterium flagellum is also of whiplash type. It is just like a hunter. It is broader at the apex, whereas it goes on capering toward its tip. So such type of flagella, it is known as whiplash type. When it is in the form of a feather, okay, so feather like flagella, it is known as tinsel type. These types of flagella are found in the gametic cell. Okay, zoospores are there. They also have whiplash as well as tinsel types of flagella. Most of the spores of lower organisms or the lower plants, they show these type of flagella. Even though sperms, okay, sperms also have flagella. So these flagella are responsible for movement of cell. Fine. So we'll mention some examples. Zoospores of bryophyte algae. Okay. Example, zoospores of bryophytes algae. Okay. Example of whiplash type sperms. Okay, sperm cells or the gamete cells of higher organisms. Okay, they have whiplash types of flagella. So these are differences in cilia and flagella. I hope now you have understood. Although both of them, they perform similar type of function. So here function of flagella we can mention. Flagella performs only single function, that is locomotion. Okay. Cilia perform some other functions also along with locomotion, but flagella performs only function of locomotion. They are responsible for locomotion of cell. Right? So these are differences in cilia and flagella. Okay. I hope you have understood this point. If you have not clear, just watch this video again. Okay, note down all the points properly. You will understand. It's very easy. Now, after this, we'll study the structure of flagella. Fine. Structure of flagella and cilia. As I told you, internally they show a similar type of structure. In prokaryotes, you have studied structure of flagella. Fine. Students, prokaryotic flagella and eukaryotic flagella, they are structurally different. Prokaryotic flagella, you have studied in the structure of bacterium, that is made up of three components. There is a basal body, there is a hook, and there is a actual ear flagella. That flagella, it is made up of protein flagelli. But these flagella and cilia, they are made up of microtubules. Okay? Yesterday while studying cytoskeleton, I told you that these microtubules, they are involved in the formation of cilia and flagella. While studying structure of centrioles also, I have told you that centriole form the basal body, okay, from where the cilia and flagella, they form. Fine. So now let's study what is the structure, internal structure of cilia and flagella. Now these cilia and flagella, they are membranous structure. They are covered by a membrane. A membrane is present outside of that. So internal structure of cilia and flagella. As I told you, cilia and flagella, internally they have similar type of structure. Fine. So we will discuss structure, one structure, okay, in which I will explain you, okay, how it is applicable for cilia and flagella. Fine. Now let's start the internal structure of cilia and flagella. Now these cilia and flagella, these are membranous structure. Okay, so there is a membrane, or these cilia and flagella, they are surrounded by a membrane. Inside the membrane, there is an actual core or the middle part of cilia and flagella, that is known as axoneum. So inside this membrane, there is a core part, there is a main part. Okay, this main part of cilia and flagella is known as axoneum. This is just rough sketch I have drawn to understand the part. So there is a plasma membrane. This middle core, it is known as axoneum. Okay, we are going to study the structure of axoneum. The central core of cilia or flagella, it is known as axoneum. This axoneum, it is surrounded by a layer of plasma membrane. So these are your membranous structure. Right? Now let's see what are the parts of this axoneum. Okay. So for that, I'm going to draw big diagram again. Just watch this diagram carefully because number of parts are there and direct questions can come on its structural parts. Fine. Very important diagram. If you want, you can open your NCERT also. Okay, so that you can understand this in proper way. Fine. Now, as we discussed in the previous class, that cilia and flagella, they are composed of microtubule. So these structures are composed of microtubule. There is a special arrangement of microtubules which is called as 9+2 arrangement. This is a very favorite question. Okay, for NEET examination, what is the arrangement of microtubules in cilia, flagella, centrioles, whatever it is. So internally there is a 9+2 arrangement of microtubule. Now we will see what is this 9+2 arrangement of microtubule. Whatever we are drawing here, now this is the membrane. Okay, this is the plasma membrane, outermost layer. This is a membranous sheet of your cilia and flagella. Inside this there is a central core. That central core, it is known as axoneum. It is composed of microtubules. Now let's see in what way these microtubules are arranged. Fine. There are groups of microtubules. Each microtubule or each group, it consists of two protofilaments. Okay. So these are known as doublets. Okay. In the last class, we have seen about triplet while we studied the structure of centriole. There are 9 peripheral triplets, okay, of microtubule. In the same way, here also there are 9 peripheral, okay, microtubule doublet. Each group, it is made up of 2 protofilaments, so we call it as a doublet. Fine. So it consists of, I am drawing this part separately to explain you. So in the peripheral part, okay, in peripheral part there are 9 doublets. There are 9 doublets of microtubules. Okay, what is there peripherally? There are 9 doublets of microtubule, 9 groups of microtubule. Each group consists of 2 protofilaments, so we call it as a doublet. Now how it looks? This is 1 protofilament. Okay, for this just recall the structure of microtubule, that each microtubule, it is a hollow tube like structure. Okay, it is made up of alpha and beta, okay, subunits. We can also call it as a A and B type of subunit. Fine. So in this way, such 2 groups, so one it is complete and another is slightly inserted or present just behind the first one. Okay, so 2 groups or 2 doublets, we call it as a A and B. So this is A, this is B. This is your microtubule doublet, okay, peripheral doublet, which is made up of microtubule. This A type of protofilament, it is composed of 13 pillars or 13 protofilaments. Okay, so A microtubule, B microtubule. Okay, this is made up of 13 protofilaments. A is composed of 13 protofilaments while B is composed of 10 protofilaments. Yesterday we have studied that what is these protofilaments. Protofilaments, it is a column which is formed by alternate units of alpha globulin and beta. Okay, so alpha and beta tubulin, they form one protofilament. So such 13 protofilaments are present in A type of microtubule and 10 protofilaments are present in B type of microtubule. So such 9 doublets are present, okay, at the peripheral side. Along with this, there are some arms also. There are some proteinaceous arms, okay, which are attached to this A microtubule. Fine. First we will draw these 9 microtubules, okay, then we will draw the remaining structure. So I'll just position out these 9 microtubules. ओके वन टू थ्री फोर फाइव सिक्स सेवन एट आई जस्ट शिफ्ट दिस हैव टू रिड्यूस दिस स्पेस ओके सो आई हैव पोजिशन दिस सो दिस इज ओनली द ए नाउ असाइड टू दिस आई विल ड्रॉ बी माइक्रोट्यूबुल ऑल्सो ओके सो ए एंड B microtubules. So these are your peripheral doublets. Okay, there are 9 peripheral doublets, A and B. We have labeled this A and B. So this one is A. Okay, this one is B. Okay, these doublets they are also attached to each other by means of A. to B linker. So there is a proteinaceous bridge, proteinaceous linker which is present in between adjacent microtubules. Fine. So just label these parts. This is what? This is the proteinaceous sheath. Proteinaceous sheath. We can also call it as membrane. Okay. These 9 peripheral doublets of microtubules, okay, 9 peripheral doublets of microtubules, okay, how many? They are 9 in number, 5. Each doublet consists of A and B type of microtubule. A microtubule is consist of 13 protofilaments. B microtubule is consist of what is composed of 10 protofilaments. Fine. These protofilaments, they are, or these peripheral doublets, they are attached to each other by means of A to B linker. So there is a proteinaceous linker. Proteinaceous bridge, okay, in between A and B microtubules of adjacent doublet. This is known as, okay, or this AB linker, it is made up of protein nexine, okay, AB linker, okay, made up of protein nexine, okay, or nexine. This you have to remember, okay, made up of protein nexine. So A to B linker, it is made up of protein nexine. So this is the peripheral part. Now attached to A microtubule, again there are arms of dynein protein. Fine. So there are dynein protein, 3 outer arms. Outside there are 3 dynein proteins, inside there are 2 dynein proteins. Okay, so these are proteinaceous molecules which are attached to only A microtubule. Inside 2 dynein proteins, these proteins are called as dyne. Okay, so inside 2 and outside 3. Okay, I am drawing the same diagram which is given in NCERT so that you will understand. Different types of questions can become based on this part. Either they can give you the diagram, they can label different parts, and they can ask you what is a name of this part or what type of function it performs. Okay, so attached to A microtubule, there is a dynein protein. 3 types are located on inner side, whereas 3 proteins they are located on outer side. Fine. So just study this diagram properly. Okay. If you will remember the structure and different parts, from that you can easily attempt this question. So these structures are known as dynein protein or arms. Okay. So these are the arms. This is outer arm. This is outer arm, and these are inner arms. right? These outer and inner arms, both of these, they are made up of protein, dynein. Fine, huh? So these also you have to remember, question can come on this. So the protein which is present on, or the protein which is present in the inner and outer arm, okay, they are known as dynein protein. So this is the peripheral part. Now let's see the center or the core part of this cilia and flagella. Fine. Now at center, okay, there are two microtubules. Okay, there are two microtubules, independent, they are not attached to each other, so we can't call it as a doublet, so we call it as a singlet. Okay, two units of microtubule, they are also attached to each other by means of a bridge. So there is a bridge which is present in between these two units, we can call it as a C1 and C2, as they are centrally located. Two independent microtubules, don't call it as a doublet, okay? So we can call it as a singlet. Yes, so these are two central microtubules, okay? Singlet, these are not doublet, okay? So singlet, two central molecules or two central microtubules. Fine, we can label it as central tubule. Central tubule. Okay, these are singlet. Okay, or they are one in number, so we can write as 1 plus 1. Now, if you can see outside or peripheral, there are 9 tubules, okay, microtubules, whereas at center there are 2. So this arrangement we call as 9 plus 2 arrangement, okay. Now you have understood from where this 9 plus 2 arrangement have come. There are 9 peripheral doublet, whereas 2 central singlets, okay. So this arrangement is known as 9 plus 2 arrangement. This is surrounded by a partial sheath, okay. So that is known as central sheath. So it is surrounded by a sheath, okay. This is known as central sheath. Okay, this sheath is known as central sheath. Okay, this is known as central sheath. Fine. So there are two bridges, two arms. Fine. This is known as central sheath. The central sheath, it is attached to peripheral doublets. Okay, it is attached to the 8 tubule of this doublet by means of radial spoke. So these structures are known as a radial spoke. Okay, the A doublet is attached to the central sheath by means of a radial spoke. So there are 9 radial spokes. Okay, while studying structure of centriole also we have seen that there are 9 radial spoke, each radial spoke from the peripheral triplet. So here also radial spoke, but it is attached to the A type of tubule. From there it attaches to the central sheath. Okay, now here this C1, C2, it functioned as enzyme ATPase. Fine. So these C1 and C2, this central tubule, they work like ATPase. Functions as enzyme ATPase. As you know that it looks also like a cartwheel structure. So whenever the cell or the cilia or flagella want to move, at that time energy it is required. So that energy will be provided by the central singlet. Okay? So they function as enzyme ATPase. They provide the energy which is required for functioning of cilia and flagella. find. So this is the internal structure of cilia and flagella. They show 9+2 arrangement of microtubules. Students, you have to remember this. Question or MCQs come on this part, fine. So there is a 9+2 arrangement of, there are 9 peripheral doublets and 2 central singlets. Okay, so we call it as 9+2 arrangement. Okay, just study the structure properly, try to understand all the parts, all labels. Okay, once you revise the structure, automatically it will keep in your mind. Okay, or you can keep the structure in mind. Fine. Now the last part from this which we will discuss. Now we have seen that internally they have 9+2 arrangement, but non-motile cilia, these are your primitives type of cilia, there are your stereocilia, they are also non-motile type of cilia. So non-motile type of cilia, they do not have central tubules, they have only peripheral tubules. So they show 9+0 type of arrangement. Again, keep this point, because MCQ can be asked in any way. Non-motile cilia, I am writing that point. You also just make star and write down. Okay. Non-motile cilia do not have, non-motile cilia do not have central tubules. They do not have central tubules. So they have 9+0 arrangement. So they have 9+0 arrangement. Okay, like, or these are known as primary cilia. Okay, primary cilia. Okay, like your stereocilia. Stereocilia, these are non-locomotory. They have only peripheral doublet. There are no central, they do not have central tubules. So they have 9+0 arrangement. Fine. So these points you have to remember. So kinocilia, they have 9+2 arrangement. Stereocilia, they have 9+0 arrangement. And now the last point which we are going to discuss, what are the differences in basal body and centriole. Yesterday we discussed that the centriole, they form the base from this cell or your cilia and flagella, they form. So that is known as basal body. But there are some differences in centrioles and ciliary body or your basal body. Let's discuss those differences and then we will finish this cell organelle. So there are centrioles and basal body. Centriole and basal body. Now centrioles, yesterday we have seen what is the position of centriole. Okay, centrioles are usually located near to the nucleus. So they are perinucleolar. Okay, they are perinucleolar, that is present near to nucleus, that is they present near the nucleus. Okay, whereas basal body, it is present just beneath the cell membrane, because obviously if the cilia or flagella is going to form from this basal body, that basal body has to be present just beneath the cell membrane so that cilia or flagella would act as an extension. So present beneath cell membrane, okay, or plasma membrane. Fine. If we consider the numbers, okay, how many centrioles are present? 2 centrioles. 1 centrosome consisting of 2 centrioles. Each cell has only 2 centrioles. But basal body could be many. It depends upon the number of cilia or flagella. Okay, so they are 2 in number. Okay, and we know that they place at a right angle to each other. So they are 2 in number. Whereas basal body, they are many in number, okay, or they are numerous. Their number obviously depends upon number of cilia and flagella, okay. Next one, centrioles are usually smaller in size. They are usually 0.3 to 0.5 micrometer in length, okay. whereas basal bodies are much larger in size, usually 300 to 500 micrometer in size. Okay, then what are the functions of centrioles? Yesterday we discussed centrioles perform, or they help in the formation of spindle fibers, astral rays, okay. But basal body, they involve the formation of cilia and flagella. So with respect to functions also they differ. They help in cell division, help in formation of aster formation, spindle fibers formation, okay. Whereas these basal body, they are involved in formation of cilia and flagella only. Okay, no doubt the structure of basal body and centrioles, it is same. But if we study some differences in cilia and flagella, okay, we can see what are the differences in cilia and flagella. Fine. So this is all about cilia. In fact, this much information is more than enough. Along with this, you can read NCERT. So today we completed one of the important synonyms, that is cilia and flagella. Fine. In the next class, we will start the structure of nucleus. Again, important part, brain of a cell. Fine. So this is for the day. In tomorrow's lecture, we will start the next cell organelle, that is nucleus.